Good morning, everybody. It is a Savage Stacker. So I want to put out this video because I haven't really done any like along the way with this challenge. And at the beginning of the year, Spectacular, the Silver Stacular, had a challenge of 1/10 ounce of gold a month for 12 months. And that's a little over an ounce of gold. And well, it is November, so I should have 1/10 ounces of gold, and I do, but not physically, which goes against everything that we talk about. One of the 1/10 is on the way. I just purchased it yesterday from Hero Bullion, a 1/10 ounce gold maple, and it is on its way. And so I guess I shouldn't count my eggs before they hatch, because you know the male's kind of crazy. But I have purchased my 11th yesterday, and I like doing this. It's so fun. They slide out so nice. So along the way, I've bought quite a few of these right here, but these proofs are also a part of that, because I put, you know, during those months, those respective months, I just didn't buy a BU 1/10 ounce. I bought a proof 1/10 ounce. And the first one here is the Type 1 for 2021 with the good box. I mean, look at this box. Look at that box. I mean, come on. Let's look at this. I don't even know if I can call it a, I guess it is a box, but boy, is it cheapo. I do like the new cards though. Those are actually pretty cool versus the older cards, right? But look at this clamshell, right? Look at that. Oh, beauty. Type 1, gorgeous. Look at that thing. Absolutely stunning. So we'll set that. This is a clamshell, beautiful clamshell. I wish they'd go back to that. Or this flimsy turd. I mean, look at this thing. Like, what is this thing? Just this plasticky, gimmicky. That's really un-American right there. I just feel like it's totally un-American. But anyways, do you remember the old blenders? You know, the Oster blenders? You remember those things? If you find an old Oster blender, like at a flea market or something, or garage sale, they're still kicking. They've been kicking around since the 60s and 70s, and they still work. Well, you go buy an Oster these days, which I have a toaster, Oster toaster over there, a new one, piece of crap, right? And I feel like this is what is happening. It's like old Oster blender versus new Oster blender. Garbage, right? Like, come on. Let's keep our stuff good and American, not cheap and flimsy. Anyways, that's enough about the box. Box don't matter. Then we got the Type 2. Now, I do like the Type 2 gold eagles. It makes sense. It's an eagle. It's a head, right? Eagle's head. It's okay. The silver eagles, I cannot stand them. I don't like them. I won't be collecting them. I do have a tube of the 2021 Type 1 or Type 2s and a few of the proofs. But if I buy eagles again and the premiums come down on the silver eagles, I will be searching out the Type 1s for sure. I don't want any more in my stack. I don't like them. I think it's a horrible design, and they did not do it justice. This doesn't bother me. I like, you know, it makes sense. The other one don't make sense. Anyways, Type 1 or Type 2 right there. Pretty sexy. It is nice. And Type 1 right there. So in their respective months, that's what I bought for my, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I got 5 of these 2021 Britannias. They're a good deal, and they're 4.9's fine. They got the security feature and all that. These are like the best coin out there for the best price, in my opinion, right now. So if anybody else follow along with this challenge right now, you should have over an ounce of gold extra added to the stack. I say extra because I have been buying other gold. And we got a Krug here. I got from the LCS for dirt cheap. Oh my God. It was literally like out the door. It was less than $200. It was like $200. I mean, with taxes and everything, he charged me. It was basically, you know, 1 ounce broken up times 10 and added tax to it. So it was a great price for a 1/10 ounce. And we got another type one here. I mean, type two, sorry. And so that's 1, 2, 3, 8, 9, 10. And I also purchased this in the middle of all that. I don't know if that counts. It's over 1/10. It's a 1.2. And, but just because I thought it was kind of cheating, I don't know, I bought another 1/10 ounce. That's what I did. I bought another one of these. And then I have a maple on the way. I just ordered yesterday, and Hero Bullion already got it sent out. So cheers to Hero Bullion, man. I think with these companies, if you order from them often, I think they take care of you. Like, I think they, I believe that they send your stuff out quite fast. Because when I first started ordering from them, it would take like 3 or 4 days, 5 days before they get it sent out. But recently, the last couple times I've ordered from Hero Bullion, they get it out either that day or the next morning. Yeah, really fast, really, really fast. And so I don't know if it's a thank you for ordering from them often, or if it's just them getting better at their job, hiring more people, getting out their metals faster, that kind of thing. So I'm not unsure. So, but Hero Bullion's been my number one lately. So, and Scottsdale Mint, a little more higher on the premiums, quality products, but there's a reason why I go through Scottsdale Mint, and that is because they don't charge me tax. So the price is the price, you know. And you get over $500 or whatever it is, and it's free shipping, and you know. So I love Scottsdale Mint. It's like my number one, and then Hero Bullion's my number two. And I used to use AppMix and JM Bullion and all that stuff, but by the time I got done paying tax and all this other stuff and the credit card fee and all these things, I ended up paying $40-$50 more than what the price was said on there, and I don't like that. And Hero Bullion used to be like Scottsdale Mint, didn't charge a tax, but now once their business makes a certain amount of taxable sales and it reaches over whatever thousands of dollars, they make them start charging tax, and which sucks, but whatever, it is what it is. And so there it is right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I don't know if you want to call that, but I got a 10th ounce maple on the way. It'll be here probably the next couple days. I'll do an update. So I want to say thank you to Spectacular for doing this challenge. And I have seen it all the way through. I don't know if anybody else has. I haven't seen any comments about it. But I don't read all the comments on other people's channels. Just, you know, about 10% of them. And see what people are saying. But yeah, it was a great challenge, and we got one more month to go. And I don't know, I think the 12th one, which is going to be hard, it's Christmas time coming up and Thanksgiving, and all my kids' birthdays are right now in October, November, December, my whole family's birthdays. So it's going to be hard to be able to afford stacking during December. But I think I'll be able to squeeze out one more 1/10 ounce of gold, and I want to get something really cool, and I don't know what it is yet. I would really like to just go ahead and pan out the money for the 1/10 ounce 2008 gold buffalo. and it can be graded or whatever, but it's going to be like 500. But I've always wanted one, so I might try to pull that off. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see what happens. Stay tuned. Thank you all for coming by. Go check out Spectacular. This was a great challenge, and I know a lot of people can't afford full ounces of gold, but I think the 1/10 ounce, I think people can pull that. And at the end of a year, it went by really fast. We have over an ounce of gold here. I mean, added to the stack. That's a beautiful thing. And so you can't go wrong with that. And premiums are up a little bit on 10th ounces, but, you know, they're not horribly bad. And it's fun. 10th ounces are nice. They're gorgeous coins. Thank you all for coming by. Please hit the bell icon so you get updated on my latest videos. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. The Savage Stacker is over and out. Take care.